इट्स गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, आई एम गोइंग टू टेल नेशनल लिबरेशन एंड मूवमेंट्स, नेशनल लिबरेशन मूवमेंट्स इन द कॉलोनीज। ऑलरेडी वी हैव कंप्लीटेड पार्ट वन ऑफ 10th क्लास सोशल 15th लेसन। पार्ट वन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट पार्ट टू। हियर नेशनल लिबरेशन मूवमेंट्स इन द कॉलोनीज। इन दिस लेसन three colonies has been mentioned. First is China, second is Vietnam, and the third one is Nigeria. These are the three countries mentioned in the 15th lesson of social 10th class. Now already we discuss about China, how China got independence, how China become republic, and who is responsible for that. All those things that we have discussed in the previous class. Now I am going to tell another lesson, another part 2 of national liberation movements in the colonies. That is about Vietnam. That is about Vietnam. Here, Vietnam is having many phases, many problems. They face many problems. Among them, the main problem is French colony from the mid 19th century. Means Vietnam was the French colony from the mid 19th century itself. At the time, the prime agriculture, the people of Vietnam gives importance to rice and rubber for agriculture, and more than 53% of the families in Vietnam are landless, means they are not having any land to the Vietnam people. US, United States of America wage a war with Vietnam. Why they wage a war means? Because fear of communist power. Communist power means Russia try to rule on Vietnam. So not to get Vietnam under control of Russia. For that purpose, Russia, America wage a war with Vietnam. Then division of Vietnam under Ho Chi Minh. So Vietnam was divided into two parts under the leadership of Ho Chi Minh. The civilizing mission, French education. Vietnam people, the French people, the French government not only given importance to cultivation, but they also given importance to educate the people. That is French education, and then emergency of Vietnamese nationalism. The last one is Republic of Vietnam under Ho Chi Minh. So how Vietnam become a republic under the leadership of Ho Chi Minh. Here, in the mid 19th century, Vietnam came under the direct rule of France, who made the emperor as a puppet. So, in the mid 19th century, the country Vietnam, this country Vietnam, is totally under the control of France, and they put one emperor, but they put one king of Vietnam citizen. And that king was a puppet in the hands of French. He became the puppet. Means he became a cartoon or puppet. What the French says, the king follows. In the mid 19th century, means in the mid 19th century, the total Vietnam was under the control of France, and the king of Vietnam was a puppet in the hands of France. So Vietnam exported 2/3 of its rice production. And by 1931 had become the third largest exporter in rice in the world. So the third largest rice exporter in the world means 2/3. For example, now they are producing rice three quantities. In that two quantities has been exported by Vietnam, means largest producer of rice is who? Means Vietnam. Other countries are also there, but in that Vietnam stand third place. And in the year 1931, it stands second place in the world in exporting rice to the other countries of the world. Here, French colonies try to educate. After getting the control by the France in Vietnam, the French started constructing some canals. Then they started constructing some canals, then railway tracks, and also they started educating the people of Vietnam. That is French education also. They started educating the people of French. That is Vietnam. So they try to give education through which they believe Vietnam civilization. Education youth organize themselves and 4-2 drive. Yes. So when the people of Vietnam has got education, then they started thinking, analyzing, and started revolting against the foreign rulers. Foreign rulers means here, you can see France is there. America is also one of the foreign rulers in Vietnam, where the people of that Vietnam has opposed under the foreign rule. Now Vietnam under Ho Chi Minh fought against France for 8 years and defeated them. Yes. Ho Chi Minh, he is one of the ruler of France, one of the king of France, you can say. He fought with France for continuously 8 years to free Vietnam from France. And he defeated France. In the peace agreement movement, Vietnam was divided into two. That is, North and South Vietnamese, in the peace agreement movement. So, in the peace agreement movement, Vietnam was divided into two parts. One is North Vietnam and the other is South Vietnam. North Vietnam, headed by Ho Chi Minh, confiscated land to the landlords and distributed among the lands to the landlords. Here, after getting the power to Ho Chi Minh, he has introduced one reforms, that is land reform movement. According to land reform movement, he has collected the land from the landlords and distributed that land to the landless laborers. After this, Vietnam has fought a war. Vietnam has got control by US, means USA has occupied Vietnam. After that, again Vietnam started fighting with the US, that is United States, and there was a big war. In that, Vietnam is one of the small country before US. Even in spite of that, Vietnam defeated US, and with the fear of defeat, USA has used one chemical weapon which we call it as Agent Orange. In that, firstly they destructed the many trees that are present in the forest. Why? Because Vietnam waged a war with the US. The name of the war is Guerrilla War. They hired themselves and fought with the British Army, where British many soldiers were killed in that. So for that purpose, the American military soldiers has used one weapon, that is chemical weapon, we can say. Due to that, the name of the weapon they used is Agent Orange. That orange we could use for a dependent plant killer, which destroyed plants and trees and made the land barren for a long time. So the main intention is to identify the Vietnam military that are hidden in the forest. For that purpose, they use Agent Orange, and also they use napalm bombs. That is a deadly bomb which causes intense damage to the human beings. So napalm is another chemical bomb which was used by US. Why they use means? They used to kill the Vietnam military. At last, the US war with the Vietnam was long drawn and got criticism even inside the US. So a long war has been waged between USA and America. Because of this war, the American citizens also got vexed with the policies introduced by the American government. And the people of America started revolting against the America and asking the government, we don't war, we want peace. In that Vietnam was freed. So the US war with Vietnam was long drawn and got criticism even inside the US, which forced it to make the peace. So at the last, finally Vietnam was unified on 30th April 1975. So finally Vietnam was unified, means Vietnam was freed. In the year 1975 itself, it was freed on 30th April. Right. Here, in Vietnam, French, what the French did means here to the Vietnam people. The French did little industrialize the economy. After independence also it economy problem predominantly dependent on agriculture. Large government industry started. So in Vietnam, what are the good activities done by France in Vietnam means? First thing is they started industrialized to increase the economy of Vietnam industries. Then the second thing is the prime economy depends on agriculture. So the French people, the French government had given importance to uplift the agriculture position in Vietnam. Another thing is later they started government industries in France, in Vietnam. So what are the general policies that they brought? What are the general means? Government readily adopted the technology and technological changes and new intervention throughout the world. It has a greater collaboration with with the third world's country to improve its industries. So fastest development we can see in the colonies means that is Vietnam. Fastest development in all aspects, in all fields that we can see in the case of Vietnam rather than the other countries of the world. So they are ready to adopt the changes for the development of Vietnam. But the other countries, they haven't adopted that much as Vietnam has adopted. In the early 20th century, Vietnamese students went to Japan to acquire modern education. So in that year, the 20th century, Vietnam students went to Japan to acquire modern education. For many of them, the primary object was to drive out French from Vietnam. So over the puppet emperor and re-establish Nguyen dynasty that had been disposed by the France. Yes. So in the mid 20th century, many of the Vietnamese students went to Japan to educate themselves and to uplift the French government, French ruling from the Vietnam. That was the main intention why many of the students went to Japan to learn to educate themselves. Right, children. The first step taken by the Vietnam government in Vietnam was the reduction of land rents. So after the formation of Vietnam, after Vietnam getting republic, what is the first step means? The first step taken by the independent Vietnam government was the reduction of the land rents. Means land rents were huge at that time. Then the Vietnam government has started a program that they should not collect huge rents from the poor farmers. The next step is, earlier most of the lands were under the control of landlords. Then they kept the land rents only, not only high, but also imposed other taxes. So the new government reduces all the land rents. Right, children? Listen to this class very carefully. One time, two times, three times. After that, start preparing the notes. Then learn that notes. After that, write without seeing in your examination, Dr. Chalam. Right, children. Thank you. Take care. Bye.